27-year female. She was diagnosed as a GUTB outside with imaging finding. Urine AFB was negative. And she was given a course of ATT, 9 months course of ATT, category 1. And she presented after completing ATT. She was referred here for further management. She had still had the loin pain. Now urine AFB again we did, that was negative. And this X-ray shows a classic putty kidney. And the CT shows grossly, irregularly dilated pelvic calluses with the contracted pelvis. And the DTPA showed no uptake at all. Over to Nitesh Jain, sir.
Yes.
Dr. Nitesh, can you show the upper abdomen? What is hindering the liver? Why the liver is not seen?
It's all attached here. I'm not able to see the liver at all.
Well, because of mental adhesions or what?
I really don't know. The colon I can see here is going down, but liver I'm not able to see at all.
You see the liver on that side?
So I don't know what can lift up.
I think it is all stuck on the whole momentum went and stuck up between the liver and the thing. I think on the left hand upper corner there was a that part is the liver. That is the liver, I think. That is the liver.
So this is the
oh, that's a pelvis.
Pelvis,
no. No, no, that is a pelvis. I know. I'm saying,
yes.
No, that's a pelvic brim. I'm talking about that area. No, no, the same area. It's now on the left side, up. No, it's okay. I think the omentum is covering that liver there.
Yeah,
That and that other side also. That side also. Same way. Yep. वो है वो 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 momentum के पीछे है. Majority of the toughest nephrectomies are always tuberculous kidneys. Diagnosed, confirmed tuberculosis is the toughest case any day. It's not the question of mobilization, the hilum.
Dr. Chandramohan?
Yes, sir.
Dr. Chandramohan, I just wanted to ask whether you would like to excise the ureter a little bit more.
No, sir, I will readjust in the proximal level.
Okay.
Because more excision, more tension.
Okay.
That ureter can be put behind the sigmoid colon. And that won't kink to my knowledge because I have not mobilized. I will keep it in the side and possibly I will take one stitch, but not much excision.
Okay.
Because this is too thick, I am trying to do first bite with 2-0, which is big, but let me see, 3-0 is ideal. I kept 3-0 also with me. One needle I have taken out or no? No, no. have to take out first. This one, huh? Yeah, take it out. I have taken out. Yeah, this is very important because two needles at a time in the abdomen is not advisable. Now I am going for the stitch. Important part is this part. This go close, Ramsna, little withdraw. Yeah. Now first is a lie. Usually lie, if you keep normally like this, see this lower part is the one outside in. I have to come first. So hold it thoroughly here without any movement and come out like this. Like this you come out. Take a thick bite, no problem. And then withdraw this a little bit. This is too thick, bite, no problem. Now I will keep my thread on this side. These are important steps I am telling. Now I will go here, inside out, I will come a thick bite here, no problem. And this needle has to come below of me now only. After that, exchanging and all is a nuisance. Now automatically both are here. I kept 10 cm only because I will waste some time, but I will not struggle with the multiple looping. Now here it is there, double loop is better here. Hold it and use this as the, even single loop is okay because this tissue will hold, it won't become so easily. Now if you want to reduce, you reduce the length so that you can use it for the one more time. Go close. Yeah, I will show that. You will always get confusion after this first bite. See, like this it will come. Okay? These two are together, Ramakrishna. You are understand? After that it will go like this. Because of this peritoneum, everything is looking dirty. Otherwise, if this peritoneum is not there, ureter looks beautiful. And tighten it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then it will not loose. This becomes loose, then it may leak. Because it's a large ureter. Now second, third, reverse, fourth. Now instead of doing the apex bite, I do differently here like what pyloplasty Anup Kumar has done. I will make it interrupted, all the stitches interrupted here, no continuous stitches. Hardly it will take three on either side. So I will take again stitch this. Now I think 3-0, you give me, I will keep this needle because this is too big needle, it may tear badly. Take 3-0 around 12 centimeters. Now on either side I will not take the apex stitch. On either side I will do, after doing 3 bites on either side I will put the stent so that my lumen will never get compromised. That is the way I prefer. And I will show this bite on the other side. Other side means where is it? Show me, it has not come. This is the needle. If two needles are there, always confusion, so one needle keep away from you. Because I am not sure whether 3-0... 3-0 is a good needle for this. So I am taking now. See, because there is a lot of mobility here, go Sridhar. This important Sridhar, you have to show well. See, this is the thing which is there. Now I have to come from outside of here to outside here. If I take, I can come like this. If I don't take, I have to take first on this. I will prefer one stitch this side, one stitch this side. So that now I will take a reverse bite. For the juniors who are there, reverse bite is not that difficult on the right hand. Like today, even with the left hand, Maryland he was showing, who are Anup Kumar. I am doing with the right hand only, but reverse, like this. Only important part is the stretch. See here, you need not go very close like this. After that, you hold the needle carefully. Don't attempt multiple times, then you get frustrated. Remove it and always first thread realign where you want to this thread. It is already in the port. So don't do any mistake with the thread. Before you take the next bite, you should know where the thread should be there. It should be outside. Outside on this side. So this is on the outside of this side. I will pull as much as possible because after taking, pulling is difficult. So pull now only, like in open surgery. Now you take a forward angle inside of lacking, so you put there and come out from here. The advantage with this is that sometimes inadvertently apex may be closed, then it becomes obstructive. In this case, even if I don't move properly, I don't mind. Patient has come primarily for obstruction. This is a one bite. Now keep it there. Forward bite. Now keep it there. Reverse bite. Reverse bite. If you want to do C loop like this, then only it will come. Every bite has to be reverse. One forward, one backward, total four. When you are doing reconstructive, don't compromise. Now I will cut it off. I will do this side. Suction please. I will do this side. After that, after like that two bites, I will put the stent by lifting it. Then it does, it means that the apex is totally not obstructing. Otherwise, you can do on either side like that also. It's a personal this thing. Go close. While cutting these stitches, always hold this and cut. Never cut directly because your stitch may cut and remove this piece also. Otherwise, it will be coming into your way again and again. Now take the needle again. See, automatically needle, if you draw like this, it will come into your line. This is the advantage on the surface. You can use the needle like this because this is primarily for suturing for the beginners. That's why I am explaining a little bit of that. See, now here simply I will take from here like this. This is a forward bite, no problem. And then pull, this thread will be on this side only again. That is very important, otherwise you will be confused. Here only, this side, no here and there. Is there any thread like this, you remove it. That will confuse and you will pull that and entire thing will come out. Now, I have gone outside in. Yeah, he's saying pull the thread so that you can, yeah, like that, keep it that side. And because there is mobility here, hold in the center and lift so that you will not get confused. And take a distant bite because this is long. As Malikarju sir said, if you have more suturing, you try to do continuous. So here you take distant bites. First 2-3 bites are very important, like in pyloplasty. After that, if you want, you can continue. Otherwise, 2-3 bites interrupted is better. Like this, if you have, then again for the this thing. See loop on the here, the abdomen is coming little bit. See loop, hold it, tighten it. See, if you are on this side, it will tighten like this.
Dr. Chandramohan, you are explaining it very nicely. It means the way you are explaining, I think it would be very useful for the people who are, yes.
Yes, because yeah. Many of the people have come for,
yeah.
See, every time this loop should go like this. See, it is not looping. Left hand should go down and right hand should be up. Then you curve it, it will curve automatically like this. So this is important.
Okay, Dr. Chandramohan, can we go to the other theater?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Dr. Nitesh,
yeah.
Can you let us know what would be the plan now?
No, the kidney is very large, so we'll try to retract it and pull down and dissect the momentum down.
Okay.
And once we go into the kidney plane and we leave the kidney, probably it should be fine.
Yeah, I also feel so.
Right now, I'm not able to put my port, the user port for nephrectomy.
Uh-huh.
So I'm using a suprapubic port.
Okay.
And a iliac fossa port with the umbilical port for the camera.
Okay.
So the vision actually, or else I'll see if I can deflate. I cannot see beyond this.
Yeah, I think you can see the IVC there down. The bluish thing is the IVC.
Just
above that. Yes, that one. Yeah, somewhere you open it, then it will be fine.
Yeah, so
that is, no, it must be beyond that. You can see some pulsations there. No, it's a large kidney. You can just take a bigger look, means take a panoramic view, you will be able to see. Yeah, this is perfect, I think. Yeah, you're correct.
Right now, I am doing the suprapubic port and the iliac for support.
Okay.
I have not inserted my epigastric and the subcostal port.
Okay.
Still. Come. Shambhu, where is the babu? Lay down and come. Here, lay down.
That where is this one?
So once I see some anatomy, probably with swas below and this ureter, I'll just go along the swas and ureter, and as I go up, probably later at the near the hilum, I'll see what can be done for the other ports. Come show me. We need to do some adjustment here. One support actually we have to remove because I am not able to move my ports because of that.
Chandramohan sir,
yeah,
we are with you sir.
Pass it. Wait. Pass it.
that stage. Yeah, pass it. Wait. Pass it. Yes, pass it. If it curves also, I don't have any problem, like as discussion was happening much on the stent. So I don't mind. Take out. See, this is a port just above the labia I have put in. Just above the labia. So there is no struggle, just not even 1 minute. One port does not make any difference. Just above the pubic symphysis and then travel. See that? And any other position you have to struggle. This is straight onto it. So anywhere if you want to put a stent, directly put above it, either subhepatic, everywhere, non-rotated kidney, ectopic kidney, one port above will make a lot of difference. And there sometimes if you put from here like this, it will take a lot of time spending here of us. Now I have 2-3 stitches to be done. Now definitely anastomosis is patent with the presence of this stent and on either side suturing. Now I will do this side suturing on my side. After that tunnel or not, I will see whether I have made adequate tunnel, that is, otherwise I will leave it suturing the wall side by of it. Now, if I don't mind taking a little bit of extra tissue here and like this, so that it is like a the transplant stitch, if you take after tunneling, you will take the buttressing stitch with this thing, because I am not here, it was going almost to the supra-pubic region, so I am not mobilized. Interrupted stitches, little loose in between, no problem. Within 1 hour the fibrin will form. They are putting too much close and making it tight, continuous suture. That is the advantage of, because the vascularity will be maintained. And that is the basic, when you have thread very small, avoid in the beginning, otherwise it will spend time. Yeah, see, sir. No, suture again. Small thread you cut, otherwise you will be suturing with other thread, then crumpling effect will come. This you don't keep any big and remove it also. Two needles are there, I want to remove them. Needle holder, please.
Dr. Nitesh?
Yeah.
Have you seen the liver?
No, the liver, I feel this is the liver here.
Okay.
Come out. And this probably here the duodenum. I'm going parallel to the IBC in a small window there.
Okay. We can see that.
Small window.
Yes.
And I'm just dissecting there. So upper pole I'm able to reach.
Okay.
But still there is no space to put my port there, because I don't know till what level the liver is coming.
Okay.
So I don't want to put a port through the liver.
Okay.
So still I am dissecting with those two ports only, but probably I have reached almost up to the high level.
Yeah, very nice.
So I think it's only suprapubic and iliac fossa port we are doing in nephrectomy.
You are extremely doing great. I just, and you got the duodenum off. You don't know whether you see the liver or not. It doesn't make any difference. You identified the ureter, you identified the psoas.
So,
No. You are just proceeding. You see, at one point you will not be able to progress. Then think about it. You are able to progress the way you are. But I still feel, once you saw the duodenum, I don't think liver will be right up to that lower level. I don't know what is there in the anterior abdominal wall. No, I understand. This is what happens.
I don't know what is it.
No, you'll see sometimes even the transverse colon got attached completely to the anterior abdominal wall. In any approach for tuberculous kidney is a difficult. That's difficult. You see, retroperitoneum gets you the hilum faster, but rest of the things don't change anyway. See, there are two things. Whenever somebody yesterday was presenting, I was telling Nitesh, beware for root. You remember that? Beware. Why? You have a large tuberculous kidney. Take it from me that rest of the tissues are going to be attached to the abdominal wall. You have a small tuberculous kidney, situation is different. All tissues come towards the kidney. You see the CT scan, right from the anterior-abdominal wall to the posterior-abdominal wall, the kidney has taken the position. So the rest of the things get stuck between the kidney and the abdominal wall. That's what exactly is seen here now.
Nitesh?
Maybe I think you should put in a pot and take off the lower pole totally and then take it onto the anterior abdominal wall. That will...
Come back.
No, I know it is not easy. It is a compartmentalized abdomen. You can, anyway, the way you are doing that, I think that... No, just release that thing.
These adhesions can come off. Now.
These lower pole adhesions can come off so that the pole gets lifted and you will have a much more better view across. Even if not, it's okay. The lower pole additions can go off now.
But whatever you have done, extremely good, dear. No doubt about it. In fact, the attachment what you have to the lower pole can be divided and you can pull that so that the whole kidney can be delivered even without doing anything beyond. Okay, you may need to change.
नितेश क्या फर्क पड़ेगा यार काटना है या कुछ भी नहीं है उसमें
नहीं
नो दिस इज कंपार्टमेंटलाइज
अपडोमेंस व्हेन इन डाउट यूजुअली आई पुट अ वेरी नीडल एंड जस्ट सी वेदर आई एम कमिंग इन द राइट प्लेन एंड देन आई पुट द पाइप पोर्ट.
Something is there, man. Something is there, Nitesh. Leave it.
I think we have to do with these two ports.
Oh yeah, you will do it. No issues. Aram se kar lo. Nahin, just possibly take off that lower pole. Aapko, aap kheech sakte ho niche uske baad kidney ko. Oh yes, that one, yes.
Chandramohan sir,
yes,
we are with you, sir.
Yeah, so I completed the retrovis mucosal anastomosis bladder. I will tunnel, 4 stitches may come. It is after the emptying, like when you see like this, my aim is not to completely tunnel it, to be honest. So if I can sit like this, see the breath is sitting on this, means I can put it like this. That is up to here I will put it, these 4 stitches will come. One from distally I will come, because that will be easy for me, like that from proximal to this thing. That will become my last part. After that I will put the drain. and see where you have really made this thing. So I will go into this view only, not towards the mucosa. Because if you take the mucosa, entire purpose is gone. Now here also, I will just come above the last fiber of this. And pull it, pull it. This pulling also, never pull out of your view. Pull only up to your view, because if you go into the port, like yesterday Arvind Garble was telling, once it goes into the port, either it will get damaged or it may injure the other tissues also. So this is the first bite. I will see carefully whether it comes easily, like lift like this, and then stay there. That's all. That's all, because some amount of adhesions anyway will form. So rotate. This is the other way, keeping long thread and rotating. For this you have to rotate the needle counterintuitive like movement what polycarbon sir says. Rotation is easy, whereas going side is difficult. So in suturing, if you rotate, I will show in one bite for the juniors who are there. Because when you are doing with 2-0, you can demonstrate very well. All your chicken modules, everything, you practice with 2-0 Vicryl. This is the most friendly Vicryl in Ethicon, because it is sharp, at the same time it is big and suture is thick. Now again here, withdraw like this, go only laterally, only the muzzle, not the, like this. Hold it, never take two bites in important areas. Hold it, in fact if possible, withdraw the thread, that what I have shown before during the anastomosis. Here also this is the last fiber. So last fiber onwards you come. See it is rotating here, so keep it straight. Pull it, rotate it like this. Pull 1, 2, 3, 4 like this under vision. When it is there, you make the C loop here like this, C loop. Always kiss this instrument and go below. Now I have gone below. Next time you have to go. Here you cannot take any tissue, otherwise it will crumple. Again, C loop, under, take only. This lot of people will face this problem where because of the tissue it gets crumpled. So keep it 1, 2 like this, so that memory will be there. Now you will go above, like this, above. And go here. Now you keep it below. Now you go under. Now rotate. Hold only tip. This requires certain experience to hold only loosely. You in the beginning you try to hold tightly so that you don't leave the tissue. Now above. So automatically it will be getting squared. See rotation and this thing. Now I have taken two bites. Maybe one more bite. If I am happy, I will stop it there.
So Malik sir.
Always cut these pieces, because if you suture with other one, it is not at all good. These pieces. Never keep this big. Now take it out also. For last bite, whenever you needle kiss like this, it is difficult. So hold it, turn like this. Automatically it will turn. This is the most common method apart from the on the floor base where you do this thing. This may be the last bite I will get. Otherwise it will get buried. So now go close, Sridhar. Now, see needle is not in a correct direction. How will you know? Always hold it. See like this. Then you two-dimensional become three-dimensional. Now, withdraw this. See now it is coming nicely. And only zeros are you take. There is no need to grow so much. See it is a groove. This is the muscle. And this is the last bite I will be taking. Otherwise, the ureter get compressed. So, aim is non-obstructive anastomosis. I don't know how far I justified for tunneling. I am sorry for that. But I wanted to make small tunnel. So, I did it. Otherwise, end on reflexing anastomosis. 32 years completed family life. Female low pressure bladders. So, should not be a problem. See, this place is there. And then again from down, hold gently up, rotate, automatic C loop will come above, gently rotate, this will come automatically down, rotate.
Chandramohan?
With this, 1 minute, sir.
Okay.
Only let me take out the 1 minute, sir. See, now, this part I have not mobilized. This play, there is no problem. If it is required, see, this play won't get any this thing. Once this column goes and fixes like this, there will not be any problem. So now, now we can distend the bladder and see also. With that, my surgery is over. I don't want to take any more bites. Thank you very much.
Show the port sides from outside view.
Outside port side.
Where is your camera port?
Yeah. My needle is taken out. Huh? What are you talking? I have taken out all the needles. What can you say? Two needles. Two, my 3 mm I have taken out. Last two I have taken out. Check, please. 1 minute, Kashi.
Oh, okay, Chandramo. Chandra.
This was the line where I have to do entire surgery.
Yes.
This was the line.
Yes, yes.
Then these two ports to give two instruments. This was my azimuth angle. This was my azimuth angle like this. Half I have kept.
Yes.
Left side go more up, right side down. Your surgery will be like this or this.
Yes, yes.
Right will go first, left will can go wrong. Right is important, surgery should be nearby. And this Ramakrishna was withdrawing this bladder so that the lumen is open always, otherwise it sticks. This is suprapubic just above the labia majora, just to go just above the ureter so that directly it went in.
Yes, sir.
So 5 ports. So with this, with your permission, thank you once again. And I will keep this column, now tilt the patient that side, entire column goes, so there is no need to stitch. Drain, please.
Thank you, sir. We will go with the presentation with Dr. Mallikarjun, sir. He will explain about the lap partial nephrectomy.
No. Yeah. Thank you. I think Chandramohan, that was a manipulation angle between the two instruments. Azimuth angle is between the telescope and the instrument. That's a manipulation angle. Well, thank you very much for the opportunity. We have some appointment at 5 o'clock, so I had to rush around. Laparoscopic partial nephrectomy, how do I do it? I think I do the same way like everybody does. I don't think there's anything new what I do, but possibly there are some small tips which I always think about sharing it. First thing you should understand is, there's so many ways of doing a partial nephrectomy. You have polar resection, enucleation, wedge resection, and enucleo resection, which has come after the robotic thing has come up. When you look at robot and when you look at lap, there is a difference between the two. Robotic is mostly enucleo resection, where we create a plane by separating the tissue, and that is the reason which is possible in robot because of a hinged instruments. Whereas in lap, it is not possible. You have a straight instruments, and majority of us will end up in having a sharp dissection and a wedge resection being done. Is it possible is the first question to be answered before you attempt a laparoscopic partial nephrectomy. You have a scoring systems which tell you how complex or how difficult it is. Look into it if you are fine with it. Number two, assess your feasibility of doing a partial and your competence of doing it. Both have to be assessed before you think about doing a partial nephrectomy. Margins, ischemia, and complications. These are the three factors which need to be understood. Are we giving a fair, decent margin? Are we getting into the tumor? You need to have a better understanding of the radiology, thickness of the tumor, extent of the tumor into the corticomedullary area, into the sinus, and that will give you an idea about how much you need to resect. Number two, ischemia. How to counter? How many arteries are there? How many clamps have to be placed? Whether you need to clamp the vein or not. So that will show about the ischemia and the complications that can be encountered if you are failing to do a proper surgery that have to be assessed. So you need to balance these things out. You don't need to have a small ischemia and having a positive margin. You may need to have a negative margin with a little longer ischemia, which sometime probably might be taken, maybe acceptable. There is no fixed port position, as I always say. If you are not happy, put extra two more ports. If you are not happy, have one more extra port. This is one of the partial nephrectomies which we resulted in having it after the end of the procedure. This is for the right hand instruments, this is for liver retraction, this is for the Satinsky, this is for not getting a good angle, so we had to replace two more instruments, and this is for an assistant port. So there is nothing like having only five ports, three ports, five, six ports. It doesn't make any difference whether you have 10 ports also. A small short video of a classical partial nephrectomy, what we usually see. That is a regular video which I am seeing. I have an understanding about the tumor, extent of the tumor, plan the surgery, whether to do an unicellular resection or most of the time wedge resection or excision of a polar nephrectomy or anything like that. But you see a significant amount of tissue which is quite normal here. So you may think about doing a... what is happening? Why it is not running? The video is not running. Oh, now it's playing. Now it is playing. It's okay. Okay. Now we start dissecting on the colonic reflection. I don't think the colonic reflection is any way different from anybody. It's the colon reflection on the left side or the right side. But we start dissecting the tumor on the kidney on either side, on the lateral margin of the IVC. So that is the creation of the lower window on this area, and you divide this xerotes fascia all around. Xerotes have to be divided. Majority of the times you tend to dissect the pedicle without dividing the xerotes fascia. Divide the xerotes fascia, identify the artery. This is the lower window. You don't need to dissect much further, and then you proceed the dissection towards the upper part, wherein you divide the xerota all right up to your lateral margin of the kidney below the liver, and then dissect the, make a window above and dissect the kidney away from the adrenal gland. So you have made two windows on either side and the artery which has been dissected off. This tumor is somewhere in the posterior aspect, posterior lateral aspect. So I am dissecting and lifting the pole of the kidney to make it exposed. How much mobilization of the kidney is necessary? It should be mobilized in such a fashion that the whole thing is in front of you, and when you put a suture line across or put your suturing instruments, majority of the suture line is coming parallel to you. That is a better way. So that amount of mobilization is necessary. Too much of mobilization, it starts wobbling this way, that way, and you need one more instrument to stabilize the kidney. So mobilization is according to the need, and so that the suture line comes into picture. And most of the time, majority of the partial nephrectomies don't require complete mobilization. Unless it is upper pole or posterior, then only you need to flip the kidney or rotate the kidney, then only it is necessary. Posterior hilar tumors or upper pole or posterior tumors require a complete mobilization of the kidney. Rest of the times it is not necessary. Once you are free enough that you have mobilized the kidney, and that is the tumor which has been identified, the fat pad left onto the tumor and made some element of dissection onto the surface of the kidney, exposing the normal kidney before suturing, identify the tumor and edge of the tumor. This is the margin which is need to be identified as and when possible with a ultrasound, or as otherwise your 3D judgment in your own brain, seeing the CT scan of the what is a good CT scan, what is available. Following which, once you are ready, clamp the artery. We don't clamp the vein. Previously we used to use a Satinsky, even now I do a Satinsky when there is a too much of pelvic dissection necessary, or there is a lot of fibrosis there, and then we start incising. We don't make any mark before, we start incising it, and you see that we make a horseshoe incision. We don't do a circular incision, we make a horseshoe. Only half of it is done. You don't need to make the rest of the half of it, you don't need. And then deepen the incision to certain extent, so at one point you start exposing the central area. What is your idea? You need to see the sinus fat. This is our way of doing it, sinus fast first approach. See the sinus fat. At one point, you see the sinus fat coming inside. And you see the sinus fat now. See that? That is the sinus fat which is seen. Once you see the sinus fat, that means the depth of resection has been achieved. So you then extend it at that level and take out a wedge of the kidney from that sinus fat level. So saw that and you extend in the same fashion. See the sinus fat and extend. What are the advantage of this sinus fat? If you have a tumor getting only in the cortex and you go across in the medulla, you see multiple vessels and you require multiple ligatures which will happen. If you go up to the sinus, you have a calyceal infundibulum, you have two or three pairs of artery and vein on either side of the infundibulum which can easily be stitched with two or three independent individual sutures. So I would always prefer to have that sort of a wedge resection right up to the sinus for a better hemostatic control too. Whatever medulla you left behind inside has got no meaning to the renal function per se. So there is no point even leaving that small part of the medulla. So once that half circle is over, the rest of the half circle can be done because it is an extension of the incision across and it is divided and at the end of it see the surface that you have not gone through the tumor at any place. That's a sinus fat, that's a tumor seen and you have not gone through the tumor. That is the first thing to be seen. And now you inspect the area, you vein is not clamped, so there is a venous bleed which comes in. So wherever the venous bleed is coming is a point of your artery and vein sitting together. Veins are not separate, arteries are not separate. They are all sitting at one place together. So wherever there is a venous retro bleed coming up, that is a point of identification of the tumor what is there. So identify and make 2-3 interrupted sutures wherever it is there. Cortical bleeding happening from the cortex need not be sutured because it will come anyway in your suture when you take a cortical bite. You don't need to suture. Whatever is there in the medulla or into the sinus area can be sutured. So 3 or 4 sutures, there are only 3 sutures placed here. That's enough. And then you take a cortical bites now. Take full thickness of the cortex 1 centimeter away from the margin. It is a very close look to the kidney surface area. So you feel as if there is a large margin of kidney parenchyma being taken into the suture and it becomes ischemic and no function is there. I can understand that. But I prefer, as I said, I prefer to have a good hemostasis rather than maintaining another 5% of renal tissue per se. So that's my concept. So you start suturing it. I don't put any surgical or anything in between because post-operative assessment of that foreign body becomes more difficult. And sometimes you end up in having this sort of a problem. That's the reason why, in spite of not giving an incision before, this sort of a problem has happened. If you have a problem like that, you need to take a bite right up to the capsule. Don't take a bite without a capsule. It's a waste. It just cuts through. So having a capsule in the bite is mandatory. Open the thing and see for hemostasis. There may be a little bleeding from the cortical surface occasionally, but majority of the times it settles. Wait for a few minutes, see that keep the kidney in the same position and majority of times it settles. And after you are satisfied with the hemostasis, keep the kidney in the same place and fix it if it is completely mobilized, or give a fixation to the peritoneum, to the peritoneum to peritoneum that fixes the kidney in that place. We put a drain. Whenever there is there are some cases where we don't put a drain now, but majority of the times we end up in having a drain. So basically to understand, to conclude, rather I was 8 minutes time, I would say don't take it as a very simple procedure. Number two, you need to have some amount of refinement of skills. Do a 50 or a 60 nephrectomies. Be happy with your nephrectomy, then do start doing it. And then adapt to the situation. There are expected complications, there are some unexpected complications. Answer yourself, question yourself. Suppose the bleeding happens, overbleeding happens. Have you have a consent for a radical nephrectomy? Are you prepared to do that? Or if you open up, can you do an open partial nephrectomy and come out? Don't do a radical nephrectomy just whenever the partial nephrectomy is possible, just because laparoscopy is not feasible. Predict the problem fast. Time available is short, so predict the problem fast. Thank you very much.
Sir, before we say thank you, Malikarjan sir, such a good presentation.
Arvind.
Yeah, any question?
Sir, I wanted to ask, in which cases will you apply Satinsky and which place will you apply Odeaflo?
There are.
I wanted to ask that whether still you give mannitol or Lasix?
Nothing. We don't give anything. We don't give anything of those things, mannitols, Lasix, nothing, no ureteric catheter, nothing. There is nothing being placed. two issues. There are some cases wherein there are multiple vessels, two, three vessels, and there is a right-sided renal artery with flanning off of the vessels. I don't wish to put a Satinsky with that. Sorry, I don't wish to put a bulldog, because you need to dissect each and every vessel and you need to spend a lot of time inside the hilum. That is one case where I prefer to do a case Satinsky. There is some other cases wherein. Second thing is, there are some cases where you see a lot of hilar lymphadenopathy, inflammatory lymphadenopathy. Your dissection becomes very painful. So make a window on either side. Think about a Satinsky at that places. So whenever it is a single vessel, night's hilum, single vessel, anyway vein we are not clamping, I'll opt for a single bulldog coming there in place. I hope I answered.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
A small token of appreciation from our side, sir. Please accept it.
Thank you, sir.
I also request... Dr. Nitin Kekare, sir, please. Dr. Anup Kumar, sir.
Anup sir is leaving now. Muruganandam.
Arvind Ganpale, sir.
He came actually from Egypt directly day before yesterday. Night again 10 o'clock he went. Next day again continuously. Very active, sir.
Hey, he came through Iran or what?
Dr. Abhijit Patil, sir. Last. Mallikarjun Reddy, sir.
He is a junior consultant in
Mallikarjun Reddy.
He came to help Arvind Ganpale. So he was there entire 2 days, especially day before yesterday. He helped a lot for chicken pyeloplasty.
Mallikarjun Reddy, sir. Sir, Mallikarjun Reddy.
That type of surgery
you can only do, sir. Nitish, sir. Sir, we have dissected the hilum.
Yeah, we have seen just now.
I'll be converting my 5 lumen suprapubic port to 10 mm because I'm not able to put
again for sir.
Nitesh, Dr. Nitesh.
Yes, sir.
Excellent dissection.
Sorry, sir.
Excellent dissection.
Thank you, sir. So you can see we have inserted a port in the pelvis.
Yes, so now for the first time you will be having three ports, right? Okay.
Any subcostal port. I'm operating through it. Just see the external. Can put it
directly like that. Yeah. Can what is the
5 mm? Put it straight, sir.
This is the epigastric area. This is the subcostal area. Here is the rib margin. So my port is, one is in the suprapubic area. Other port is in iliac fossa and the umbilical port.
Okay.
Here I'm not able to still go because I don't.
Okay. Yes, we can see it very well.
Still, if you see, we are not able to see the liver still. Everything is stuck here.
Yes, I think the liver is getting self-retracted.
But we wanted some liver actually. So.
I feel the cameraman is also doing an excellent job.
He is doing very, very good job. I think it's a very difficult. We don't
yes.
know the anatomy to do. It's not a routine way we do.
Yes, I agree.
Nitin sir,
yes.
Nitesh sir, we'll be watching you sir. We'll have a last presentation. We'll go ahead with that because of time constraints. Thank you sir.
Cutting the artery, you can see the lumen there.
Yes sir, yes sir.
And the vein is already dissected.
Yes sir.
You can see the vein there. We have already dissected the vein. So I'll keep the vein.
Right, sir. We'll go ahead. Okay. Abhijit Patel sir.
Dr. Chandramohan sir and Dr. Ganpure sir for this opportunity. After all this expert talks and surgeries, I dedicated this talk to the novice surgeons who have just started the laparoscopy. So what is the problem in suturing in laparoscopy is 2D image, no depth perception, and there is a learning curve. So the flow of the talk would be, first laparoscopy instrumentations for suturing, ergonomics in suturing, suturing techniques and how to reduce the learning curve. So what are the basic requirements for good intracorporeal suturing is a good needle holder, assistant, HD vision with 30 degree scope and an appropriate suture. So coming on to the instrumentation, first is needle holder. So there are different types of needle holders available in market. First one is the Ethicon grip, the Karl Storz pistol grip, palm grip or the finger grip. It is all surgeon preference, but one thing is that once you are used to a needle holder, stick to it for the rest of your life. Then comes the needle holder according to the tip of the needle holder. So it could be a straight, curved or self-righting. So self-righting is you can directly hold it, the needle holder will automatically orient the needle in the same way you want it. But you cannot, it will be 3:9 or 9:3. You cannot change the angle in the self-righting, which can be taken care in a straight tip needle holder. This is a new novel prototype needle holder device at Nadiad. It is a 3x5 needle holder. So the advantages of this is, as discussed in the morning, we have a 5mm port. The proximal part of the needle holder is 5mm. So there is no wobbling in the port, but it gives you the benefit of a 3mm tip, so that it is useful for handling smaller needles like 40 micrel, and also is useful when you throw the knot, so it comes out very easily. And also it doesn't have a small screw, so the knot doesn't get entangled in it. So this is so always invest in a good needle holder for good intracorporeal suturing. Coming on to the suture ideally should be good knot, adequate tensile strength, flexible, resistant to infection. These are the characteristics of ideal suture. So suture size makes or breaks your surgery. So whatever generally what we require in pyeloplasty or ureteric implant, 3040 should suffice, and urethral vesicle anastomosis we generally use 30 barbed suture, generally strata fix or B-lock. Suture length is of utmost importance for intracorporeal suturing. Too much of length causes problem and then leads to degradation in the surgery. So the ideal length in laparoscopy milieu would be 6 inches or around 10 to 15 centimeter. In urethrovesical anastomosis, we make it 15 plus 15, we generally use the strata fix. So 15 plus 15 and then we come from the 6 o'clock to 12 o'clock on both sides. Different types of suture needles which are available is most commonly we use is a half mm, 1/2 half circle, 25 mm needle. Sometimes insertion of the needle is a problem, but generally it is taken care in most of the cases. Then ergonomics in suturing. It is open versus laparoscopy. Ergonomics generally plays a very important role in a laparoscopic milieu. So as you can see in this key, this is a 2D, this is a problem of laparoscopy. If you keep two of your fingers and you just try to bring in front and back, you still see they are besides each other, but they are in fact moving in front and back. So you need to have some depth cues in it. See, as you can, as the scope was going near it, you can have a depth cue from the shadow of the needle. So these are the cues that one should have, because laparoscopy has a limitation of two dimension. Ergonomics is very much important, especially in reconstructive surgery. May play a less role in surgeries like nephrectomy, but it is very much important in surgeries where you require intracorporeal suturing and you want to practice for long purpose of your life. So level of the instrument, the handle should be at the level of the elbow. The elevation angle is between the instrument and the body of the surgeon, actually, body of the patient. It should be ideally 30 degree. Then as discussed Since morning, manipulation angle is between the two instruments, it should be around 60, not more than it. If it goes more than 60, your arms get abducted and then it causes fatigue. Azimuth angle is between the scope and each, and it should be around 30 on both sides. So this you can see, the angle between the two blue lines is a manipulation angle, and between a red line and a blue line is an azimuth angle. This is an important concept, especially in reconstructive surgeries. So first is a straight line gaze. So what does it say is surgeon, telescope, target and monitor. All should be in the straight line. The other is triangulation. Your both instruments and your target should form a triangle. And this overall forms a baseball diamond type. So here is the surgeon, instruments and target. So this is of utmost importance if you want to have a proper suturing and with less fatigue and less time. So this you can see, the surgeon, this is the 10 mm is for camera, you have the target pelvis and then you have a screen. So this there was a beautiful paper studying on the ergonomic factors on task performance during surgery, laparoscopic surgery training. So what they found, what is the condition A is actually a very ergonomic position. So here where you have the distance between you and the screen is around 60 centimeter. Then is your elbow height and then there is a surface height. So a surface height should be around 80% of your elbow height. Then is your eye level height from the ground. The monitor height should be less than always. So your neck should be facing down. There should be flexion at the neck rather than extension of the neck. So this is an example of how you have a straight line gaze and an ergonomic position. So what is ideal ergonomic is, head should be straight in the axis of the trunk without rotation or extension of the cervical spine. Neck should be slightly fixed in the straight line with the monitor. Gaze should be down. Shoulders in relaxed and neutral position. Arms should be alongside of the body. If you see, many of the surgeons would be operating like this suturing. This is not a correct thing. After some time, this will fatigue and then you will have tremors and then you will lose the suturing part. So the arm should be along the side of the body. Elbows should be bent around 90 degree. Forearm in horizontal and hand should be pronated. So the suturing should happen only at the wrist movement. It should not happen at your shoulder movement. So this is an example of very bad ergonomic. See the elevated angle the surgeon is having, and then it leads to abduction of the shoulder, and then finally fatigue, and then the surgeon generally loses interest in the laparoscopy. Suturing technique. So what are the four important steps in suturing is the introduction of the needle, grasping of the needle, tissue penetration, and then finally knotting. So these are the various scenarios we would have. Is a 12 mm disposable port. Here you hold a suture 2 cm away from the needle, holding a needle or insert it will go easily. If you have a 10 mm reusable port, then you will have to use a 5 mm reducer. Insert your needle holder to the 5 mm reducer, hold a suture away from the needle, take back it into the reducer and then insert through the port. If you are using a 5 mm port, 40 Vicryl generally or 30 might also be possible, but sometimes it might be tricky. It can go through some surgeons use the abdominal directly inserted to the abdominal, but the downside is it can blunt the tip, which you require actually a sharp during a pyloplasty. So the other is grasping of the needle. So there are three techniques a surgeon can grasp a needle. So for that I would like to tell you there are the three points in suture. Point A is distal 1/3, proximal 2/3. Point B is distal 2/3 to proximal 1/3, and point C is 2 cm from the junction. So the first is pickup technique, where you directly hold it at point B, and it is self-righting, so it is in the same way. So pick up by holding it. Other is a dangling technique. You hold it just a second. You hold it at point C and then make a point that you hold point B in the way orientation is required, and then you pierce the tissue. Then other example is you hold with your left instrument at point A, then you hold, I'll show you an example of it. So hold it at point A, hold it by needle at point C, you can rotate it, have a whatever orientation you want, hold it at point B and then pierce the tissue. This is very much important if you are doing a lap radical prostatectomy, you require different angles for urethrovesical anastomosis. Types of knot, we generally use a surgeon's knot and a square knot, but majorly we use a surgeon knot. So how it is done is you pierce a tissue with a left instrument, or it can be done with the right instrument also, throw two knots, hold it, it is generally 2-1-1. So this is 2, align it along the the knot, tighten it, form a C. The C is very important, this was the C, go through it, hold it. So one, two by left hand, one by right hand, and again one by left hand. So this forms a surgeon's knot. Sometimes you are in the process of doing a pyeloplasty, and then at the end you have very small length of suture. So how do you manage with it? So you use the C of the needle, you hold the needle at the tip of the needle, you use the C for the length. You have a short suture length, and then you have a C of the needle. So it gives a longer length, form an loop, and then you can easily see. Now I change the orientation, and then again you can easily make. So whatever side you hold it, make the angle orientation of the C that way, and then you can easily knot it without any difficulty. Here you can see how easily, even as the suture is getting smaller, you are able to knot it. So now how to reduce the learning curve, especially for the novice surgeons. Here are some tips and tricks. When you are doing the anterior wall, you have taken the first knot. Now since you have inserted this through both walls, keep the needle in the same orientation. See, it is going through both walls. Hold it with your left hand, keep the needle in the same orientation, hold it in the way you again insert it by holding at point B. So it will reduce your suturing time, and will also make your suture in the same line, making it perpendicular to your suture line. So finally, the thing is, even novice or an expert becomes an expert by practice. So how do we do this from dry lab to wet lab and then real time? So you can do it dry lab. You have these beetles from Ethicon, and this is a homemade mobile endotrainer device by us at Nadiad. We would be fabricating, and you would be available at very low cost for especially residents. And at wet lab, you can try the chicken pyeloplasty, as probably most have has seen yesterday how to do the chicken pyeloplasty. And then you can even try the urethrovesical anastomosis. It is between the proventriculus and the gizzard. You can try the suturing over there. So from dry lab, transition to the wet lab. There is a video of this. Then from all the points that you have gathered from this talk are summarized in this video, coming on to the human pyeloplasty. First is the suture part, the knotting part. This is the surgeon's knot which is taken. And then keep an eye how the surgeon manipulates his needle, and then how he takes through and through, maintains the orientation of the needle and holds it at point B. So this is how you transition your learning from a wet lab to a human condition. So you can see actually how it closely mimics human pyeloplasty. So even if you don't have, if you have only one patient in 3 or 4 months or in a 6 month, keep on doing chicken pyeloplasties in between, so that you have a touch with the suturing, intracorporeal suturing part. So take home message is, invest in a proper needle holder, practice the same type of needle holder through and through, 5 mm port appropriate for needle holder, just because it prevents the wobbling, appropriate suture length is the utmost importance, Port position makes and breaks the surgery as well as the surgeon. Proper ergonomics for optimum results, and finally practice, practice and practice. So the expert is anything was once a beginner, and expert is a consequence of practice. Begin, practice and then become an expert.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. That was a wonderful explanation of basics, what we require as a young urologist who are starting with the lab. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Next, we will be continuing with Nitesh Jain, sir. We are back with you.
Almost done. I have dissected the hilum. This is the upper pole little bit with the same ports only till now. So we have dissected laterally.
Yes, sir.
Sir, we are all watching you. This is a difficult case, probably the most difficult today. Nitin sir is also patiently watching. Even though it is destructive surgery, we feel sometimes easy. But in this case, because of suspicion tuberculosis, this difficulty is anticipated actually. Okay, sir. TB, sir.
Sometimes a TB
diagnosis
is made
very
likely.
Yes, sir.
Don't know.
In fact, this patient has no diagnosis directly at it is given.
Yeah.
We have seen, sir, the detailed history. Only because of calcifications in the kidney.
The kidney does get hydronephrotic, but never gets
enlarged. Yes, sir. Sir, in such cases, when everything is completed, we can give incision at the site and then...
Yeah, that's what I'm planning.
Yeah.
Just put a electrode lens sort of thing.
Yeah.
With the bowel and any other structure.
Yeah, better.
And I'll not put it
in. Because anyway, this kidney is too large.
Yeah.
If you give adequate incision,
yeah,
under vision you can, instead of spending a lot of time, because this is also crucial time when you are at the end of the surgery. Yeah, yeah, no problem. One, two reports and then under vision, remove those adhesions in the upper pole because it's difficult.
Problem is we are not able to put the
convention. Yeah.
So we have to move with some
Even camera, Dr. Rakesh, he has done really good job. The same type of case in Nadiad, single port from the iliac fossa, entire thing from the single port, sir. Everything separated like this, going like this, like this, like this. Single port from the iliac fossa, sir. Way back one foreigner has done. But because it is a plain, simple kidney, just so as he lifted on either side, little cut, last hilum he clipped with the stapler, and on either side he... And I am remembering same like stereotypic.
This is difficult. No, the adhesions, the peritoneum, the bowel is adherent on the anterior.
Yes, sir. He has not seen liver, I can't understand. Endo?
Yeah, now it's only ribbon cutting, it's all done.
Yes, sir. Exactly at the maximum point if you give incision. If finger dissection, that can be finished.
Because anywhere the kidney is big.
It has to come with a big incision.
Small incision.
So if a hand goes inside, that can be...
Break with the hand.
We can break with the hand.
But now that area will be clean.
Yes, yes, sir. Because posteriorly there is nothing. And bubble such anteriorly may not come. Close to the surface of the kidney because it's large. Nitin, sir.
Yes, sir.
If you don't mind, just we are discussing. Such a large kidney.
Yes, sir.
Because you have done 90%. Still you want to continue lap or?
I have done 98% over
Yeah, then Ajay, you want to finish in touch that?
Over, sir. Yes.
Yeah, do it. No problem.
Just this edition.
The hall is full and they are all watching. Many of the delegates are still there. So we are watching you. No, anyway, horizontal length we have to open.
Sure.
Yeah.
What is this?
Krishna?
I think this is the lever edge.
Yes. So, stay closer to the kidney.
Stay closer to the kidney, leave the pad there.
Come on.
And
okay.
Yeah, now you got some grip. That is inferior surface of liver,
Yes, sir, we are done, sir.
Yeah, thank you very much. Great surgery. Fantastic. We really appreciate Nitin. Cool as you are like any other time. Team. Fantastic.
Thanks, sir.
Great job, sir. Briefly to conclude, first of all, I thank our South Zone President, Dr. Nitin Kekre, sir, who stayed entire day watching. That is the greatness of a knowledgeable person. We appreciate that, sir, and we have to learn a lot from you. Thank you very much, sir. And sooner you will be the president in Hyderabad for South Zone conference. Hope all of us will receive you and we will have a great conference. Then our faculty, senior most, Dr. Mallikarjun, sir, again elect president, Mallikarjun Reddy, elect president of SOGAS, and Dr. Arvind Ganpule, sir, senior urologist from Nadiad, who is passionate in teaching. We all should go to Nadiad once, because I have gone every 6 months from 2007 to 2011. That's where first my laparoscopy RIRS surgery I learned in 2007. That made my life, and I thank you, sir, for giving that opportunity. Laparoscopy also, I went many times to Nadiad and Jatki, sir. That's why we could learn something. Abhijit, again, thank you for accompanying. You are junior, but you have keen interest. You have already written paper on comparison of robotic renal transplant. Nice paper, it is accepted. Best video in last 2019. He has made 200 GB video into 8 minutes. 200 GB into 8 minutes with the collaboration of the Delhi one editing person. That shows the interest. That got the video in 2019 World Congress in Urology. That's great. And other faculty, Dr. Anup Kumar, he is also now interested in teaching. Saptarjung is a very big hospital. Opposite aims, managing Saptarjung Hospital is not easy. And he is doing a lot of academic, very, very enthusiastic. We met in Abu Dhabi, then I came to know that, then I invited him as faculty. The other are Nitesh Jain and Murugarandam. Murugarandam I met in last South Zone conference. We chaired a session in laparoscopy, then I came to know that he is doing a lot of good work in Chennai. That's why we meet each other and know the youngsters how they are doing. He also worked 6 years in Jipmar, which is not a small thing. So he acquired R&D. He did from SGPGA and Jipmar MS and MCS SGPGA. And you have seen Facebook activity by Nitesh Jain. See his temperament, his cool man, his knowledge. Whenever he answers, very correctly he answers in a paragraph, 1, 2, 3, 4 points. Still, after maybe around 9 years of his private practice, he is interested in the subject. Without upgradation of the subject, we will not be able to do justice to the patient. Forget about survival, justice to the patient. With these few words, I have to say thanks to Anand Audiovisual team. Naturally, we have made inbuilt audiovisual. Still, this is the first conference in this hospital, so I called them. Apart from that, definitely, both hospitals, we have 170 staff, out of which 30 staff are in OT. That's why I can do this work, otherwise it is impossible. This is the time, first time we have not taken anybody from outside, camera, everybody. And the urology team is also unexpectedly fellowship I have introduced, then a lot of people have joined, then they wanted to stay back. Incidentally, now it is 8 urologists,
the team, I have to first one top person is Hemant from Madras Medical College. He just finished yesterday fellowship. He want to continue his consultant here because two hospitals are there. Soundarya is his wife, and she is also from the Madras Medical College. She is senior 1 year. She came first, and then he came afterwards. Both are doing roughly nearly 12 to 14 hours work. Already one paper we have published because of them, which I could not do for 8-10 years. Rakesh, you know, recently joined from Orissa, OTAS a student. He wanted to concentrate on urethroplasty, but still he is showing the camera so well. He has a lot of interest. Ramakrishna is senior to me and very instrumental last 5 years. He only says only one thing, what not to do. Even though he may not be doing all surgeries, but he knows tissue respect. He worked with 20 years with Dr. K. Ramaraju, who is a very, very disciplined plastic as well as urethroplasty surgeon. He doesn't give a single stitch till the last stitch. Even now it doesn't give to Ramakrishna. For 20 years, he says that either you go practice or don't ask me the surgery. You learn by seeing. He said recently that if I die, this ring retractor you take. That is what he said. That's what he covers our hospital, and he is extraordinary hypospadia surgeon, but he doesn't like to be in line with. So Ramakrishna learnt all the qualities. So he says, sir, no cautery, please stop it. Don't talk more. In the theater, he is continuously says that, please talk less, sir. Please talk less. You are doing anyway. Don't. Like that he was telling today. He is a negative, great energy for us. And my wife is also a very helpful radiologist. And Sudhiringa Swami is leading this hospital. He worked for 2 years here, and then he is concentrating on RIRS and PCNL. He has already gone as mentor to the Delhi for RIRS because he first joined as fellow from Ramrasa student. He asked, he is not getting job interview, but now he is in a position that entire hospital 1 year he did not call single time me for any surgery. So he is after working 2.5 years with me. I am very happy that he is able to manage the hospital. Dr. Manas is again completed fellowship, and along with Swami here, two people are managing the hospital. And last, he joined fellow from NIMS, Arjun, who is showing interest. He works for 6 months and he wants to go back to Guntur. And other people, every fourth Saturday we are conducting RIRS workshop without any registration, where 4 to 5 cases we are demonstrating from 9 to 5. No need to take the hotel, directly come, and because that's our area of interest. Now, last two years, my skills in laparoscopy improved because continuously we are watching and going to conferences. And rest of the delegates, nearly 125 delegates have come. Yesterday, 30 people have sutured. They were also very happy dissecting the, because Arvind Ganpure sir continuously was happy. See, this guy has done completely like me, this guy has done. He is so happy to see them seeing the chicken phalloplasty. This is very good. So I request all of you, please attend the conferences according to your schedule and try to learn like this, and hope this conference helped you. And thank you very much for patient being here. Thank you very much. We have mini park workshop similar like this by Dr. Ravindra Sabni sir on September 27th. It is a Sunday, 1 day program. Sir will demonstrate the mini park, only mini park, no RIRS, no PERT, nothing, only mini park and this thing. Now we also have the important team, Anastasia team, Dr. Pawan sir, and Dr. Devendar, Dr. Junior Anastasia student, I forgot recently joined. Murli, he recently got engaged. Day and night he is working with us. I don't know after marriage how he will work. Dr. Ravi, Dr. Ganesh, Anil all in administration. Most close people we take it for granted and we don't mention. But they are very, very important to all of us. Last but not least, Shabir is my contemporary. Whenever any conference happens, we did in Chandigarh together. He comes and stays happy 2 days. And his wife says that don't go to the exact day on a Chandra Monte Pass. When I go there, my wife says that too much exact must over. Thank you, Shabir, being with us always. He is concentrating on PCNL and female urethroplasty in Jabalpur. And he has his own hospital and he is doing good academic work, published papers. So with this, we conclude the session. He will open and remove it. Watch this and then please carry on. In time, we could finish. Sir, you want to say 2 words?
Thank you very much for organizing an excellent meeting. And I think all of you who came here would probably agree that whatever you came for got achieved. So I think it's time for us to give him a standing applause to the team of the hospital. Fantastic.
Thank you very much, sir. I also thank Rajendra, who is my personal secretary. You all know Rajendra's name. For 12 years he is working, he is the senior most employee. And now Chandrasekhar, Naresh, and many of the hospital team, I don't want to mention all names. Everybody has worked very hard for that. Now, every time it is going on, we record all the surgeries. 1 TB per month. And the pre-editing persons are there, they will be editing whatever. So, they have a lot of enthusiasm, they are doing it. Sir, I mean, sir.
All the sentiments that have been expressed by all the faculty. But one thing I would like to